The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome all to another exciting edition of the Power Trading Hour with me, your humble, lovable, and squeezably soft host. As always, we'd love to come to you at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
So we just had the Fed minutes out. I was reading through them as quickly as I could. And there's probably more commentary to come from the financial infotainment cable channels already in progress. But for the most part, we're basically trading where we were before. My first read of the Fed notes basically says that they don't want to tell us too much about what they're going to do in the future. Didn't sound like a lot of rate cuts. Didn't sound like rate hikes. Had a couple people dissent on what's going on, but overall, it seemed to me, again, I'd have to read last time's minutes, but it seemed to me like they continue to worry a lot more about no inflation in the market, at least nowhere near their target levels. So, you know, they want 2-3% inflation, and why there's particular things you can pick out. Overall, costs are lower. Productivity is higher. There may be a few things out there that people are buying that are more expensive. But guess what? Most people don't buy the absolute cheapest car in the world. They buy stuff that's probably more expensive than the house that they're driving. I see a lot of people in like Escalades and rundown houses. I always wondered about that. But what can you say? It is their money. It is their decision. Maybe not the wisest decision, but to buy a depreciating product right off the bat. But if there's inflation, I think a lot of it is features and more things going on. Gasoline, I bought for $2.25 yesterday or the day before. That's about what it was, 18 years ago? 17 years ago? I remember it was somewhere in that neighborhood. So I it's hard for me to get all wound up. Of course, I love that book, The Rational Optimist, about over time, everybody, there are displacements as new things come along. But over time, the great example in that book is how long it took to pay for 1 hour of light from back and being a candle to the first bulbs, to now LEDs. And 1 hour of light was a half a day's work back in the 1700s. It now takes all of about 10 seconds to pay for an hour of light for even those at minimum wage. And a lot of people, it's progress. And productivity, but products, ideas, at least in that book, his theory is that ideas and products have sex, and kind of like Darwinism, the best product eventually wins out, productivity continues to rise, people spend that money on other things, and those people that used to have jobs in other sectors go to it. If they're mobile enough to get there. But over time, I don't think I'd want to live 300 years ago or 100 years ago or maybe even 50 years ago. I guess I was alive 50 years ago. But I think you get my point. Things have done nothing but get better. Medicine's gotten better. The life expectancy has done nothing but get better. But I don't know what it was last week. Maybe it was just too many people. Maybe it was Bill Maher hoping that the stock market went to hell in a handbasket so he could get his way. But just too many negative waves. I had to go long on that.
Why don't you knock it off with them negative waves? Why don't you dig how beautiful it is out here? Why don't you say something righteous and hopeful for a change?
Always with the negative waves, Moriarty. Always with the negative waves.
No negative waves here. As I said last week, I was pretty sure that we had already come in and made a low. A lot of these stocks are beating out lows, much like they did in between 2000 and 2007, 2008. The market's acting a great deal more like it had in previous decades. And maybe that's, I think for me, it's a good thing because I think they're more predictable. But I don't know. Everybody tells me that the end of the world is nigh. Everybody's just pretty sure that it's in. But, you know, every time I've heard that, the best thing to do was to take something for it, and that was to buy stocks. I was talking to one of my subscribers the other day, and I said, as long as you can buy stocks while you're looking down the barrel of a gun, you won't have any problem in trading. Anyway, I already got some positions that are long. They kind of pulled back, but they've pretty much been doing nothing but ticking higher. We'll see how the rest of the day comes out, but I don't think that anything between now and Memorial Day, which is kind of the view I have, is going to be anything but a slow slog, maybe a stumble, like someone's had a few too many drinks, but it's going to be forward, not backwards. So I'm kind of looking for the market to go up. Options, as John from Philadelphia in the Den has shown, have been enormously bearish today. And generally, that's a good sign that you're just going to go higher, even if it's just for a few more days. Bears are almost always early and give up right before the market turns. So in the short term, in the medium term, I'm fairly bullish, and we've bought a lot of positions in the newsletter. Don't think anything else is going on. Oh, I said Memorial Day. It's Labor Day. Is it Labor Day or Memorial Day? What's the second? It's Memorial Day, right? No, it's Labor Day. Okay. I never can keep those two straight. All I know is I'm on vacation. I'm just busy setting up my air travel for that vacation into that three-day weekend. It's Laborial Day, according to my engineer. But that would be it. Anyway, we're bouncing around 22 points. 25 points higher on the S&P cash, around 250 points higher in the Dow. NASDAQ's up 64 and the Russell's up 12. And again, we're looking for fairly light volume. Some people talking about Powell talking on Friday. I don't know if that'll be a big thing. My guess is it'll be a nothing burger. Anyway, as we go to the first break today, we're doing 3.3 billion shares, which is kind of quiet. But again, probably going to get quiet every day into the long three-day weekend coming up for Labor Day.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating. This day in 1858, Senator Douglas of Illinois and Abraham Lincoln, Kentucky-born lawyer and one-time U.S. representative from Illinois, began a series of famous public encounters on the issue of slavery. The two politicians, the Northern Democrat and a Republican, Mr. Lincoln, were competing for Douglas's U.S. seat. The seven Lincoln-Douglas debates, all about 3 hours long. Lincoln argued against the spread of slavery, while Douglas maintained that each territory should have the right to decide whether it should become free or slave. And you always wonder if you can't go back to that. I mean, North and South, capitalist against communism, wouldn't be so far-fetched. It's happened before. It might happen again. We hope it does not. On this day in 1858, kind of the destiny of the uncivil war probably really starting. What else do we have? Okay. Oh, wanted to look at some charts. Had some earnings. We'll talk about earnings also after the bell tonight, which is Splunk, Nordstrom's, L Brands, Synopsys, Pure Storage, Keysight Technology. That one's been a big mover of 5Gs. They're kind of the beginning of that 5G thing and run. This will be probably the first company to top out after everybody that needs it is loaded up with test equipment for 5G. But it's up a little bit, not a whole lot of volume back in these days. But it'll be very interesting to see what they're saying. If they're starting to roll over a little bit and down, that probably is a good sign that the companies that are making stuff with the equipment they bought from Keysight are now getting ready to deliver a lot of it. And we'll look for, there's always kind of the pilgrims, and Keysight's kind of that in the 5G space and some other space with test equipment. But if they start rolling over a little bit, that basically says that most of the products that are going to come out have at least been designed, and the people that are going to buy the equipment are pretty much over. And now we're really into the second phase, which are the first products actually to hit the market. When do we go into tomorrow? Tomorrow morning before the Bell, Dick's Sporting Goods, BJ Wholesale Clubs, Hormel Foods. Yes, I could sing Spam, but I will not sing the Monty Python Spam tune now. Toro Company, that's about it. Of course, after the Bell tomorrow night. Salesforce, that could move the market a little bit. Intuit, VMware, the Gap and Ross stores, those Gap and Ross stores. Retail has not been friendly with the market. Simpatico feelings for general retail. Now, of course, today we had retail that is not clothing related, and it did actually fairly good. Target is the big winner on the day. And what can you say? Up 19%. Let's go ahead and pop that up real quick. TGT. A solid, massive breakout with volume, a sign of strength that I don't think anybody can contend with. I've been going by the store. I really don't spend a lot of time in them. The Walmart's a little closer, so generally I stop at it if I need something. I went into it last week, but it was at like 3:30 in the afternoon or something. I didn't see a lot going on. But again, that may be because of the area that I'm in. Maybe other areas, it's doing a lot better. But man, when you talk about a sign of strength, this is exactly what you're talking about. Huge gap. But as we speak to Tim Order occasionally, he likes to give this as describe this as an exhaustion move where all the volume and energy come in at once. If you know, you don't want to chase this, but if it got back down to maybe the low 90s on light volume and filled a lot of this gap, that may be a very interesting play for the fall. But both Walmart and Target looking fairly good. Lowe's, of course, a lot of home improvement. These companies seem to just continue to do better as new home sales and used home sales slow down a little bit. I think a lot of people are looking to Lowe's and Home Depot for remodeling instead of just selling supplies to local housing builders, home builders. But another sign of strength, I would have liked to seen this close higher on the day, but it went right back down to this gap from May 22nd. It was down on 22.7 million shares. You got 15 million shares already, and maybe that tells you a little bit. Yet another rip-your-face-off rally from some companies. And if the earnings continue this well, even though everybody was telling us that it's the end of the world, I can't help but think we're at least through the end of the year. It's got to be looking fairly good. We'd need something to come out of left field that I do not see that well. Some retail doing a little bit better, and maybe because it had been beaten up so bad, but Urban Outfitters, little dead cat bounce out here, but you did have very nice volume today, about 8.3 million shares. On the loser side, Cree looks like it's headed back down. It's down 14% and below the trading range set on the August 9th high of 2019 at just under $52, got to $48.24. This is a company that's going to be very hard over the long term to continue to make a lot of money. They make high output LEDs. And just eventually lower priced, lower margin manufacturers are slowly going to catch up with these guys. Are they going to have an okay business? Yes. More of a trading vehicle now though, than any kind of growth vehicle that I can think of. What else do we have out here? Tesla. We'll get into this when we come back. I had a few emails already, and you, of course, can email me at path@tfnn.com. And, of course, you can call me at 877-927-6648. But I had a couple of questions about what's going on with Tesla, and we'll tell you why. The roof is on fire at the Walmarts when we come back.
Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Hi folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And we are back to the market. Anyway, we're going to talk a little bit about Tesla. I had a few questions about why it's Solar City panels on top of 250 Walmarts. Already 7 or 10 of them have already caught on fire. And kind of interesting that Tesla wanted to get into a big fight with Walmart on this and make it go to court. But the Solar City folks decided to use DC power to transfer the power back to a bigger centralized inverter to turn it into AC and more safely move it. And one of the problems with the way that they did that is that if you took two wires coming off a lot of it, there's some pretty heavy DC amperage. But if you get the wires close, and a spark goes between the two wires, even though they're not touching, they'll form a plasma ball, and the temperature gets, 2,500, 3,000 degrees. In other countries, Canada and most of Europe, Australia, they have regulations where you can't run that high amperage DC current. You have to run it to a little box that turns it to AC, makes it much more efficient to ship that AC around and less dangerous. It's a little bit more efficient the way that SolarCity and Tesla's sell it, but this is not new. I mean, this has been going on for a year. Tesla just giving the middle finger to Walmart on the deal. But it's had problems for a while. And the only thing that's stopping more of these things burning is that Walmart sent folks up there with wire cutters to cut all the wires directly from the solar panel. So they won't have any more fires. But for 250 units to have 10 fires, that's a massive failure rate on these units. And, you know, I don't know what the liability is. Probably not that big. They probably could have settled it for a couple million dollars. I don't know why they just didn't do it and move on and worry about the bigger battle, which is selling cars. But maybe because Tesla's under fire already for buying SolarCity, and one of the major frauds, I suspect, on shareholders, and that's buying that pig in a poke, SolarCity. So I don't know. Maybe we'll do it. So maybe someone will call in and tell us. But if you're wondering why it is massive DC power between two wires that can easily spark. And if they're separated a little bit, causes a super hot plasma ball between the two, and which catches just about anything anywhere close on fire, and melts the solar panels and also destroys a lot of the equipment in the circuit. But for some reason, the U.S. didn't get in on saying what is and what isn't available. I suspect that much like some of the other issues we talked about this week, that blew up in the face of some biotechs, that will probably have some legislation about whether or not you can have long runs of DC current instead of smaller inverters nearer to the solar panels so that it's safer to move around. He experienced that a lot. He was the DC guy. But, of course, all solar panels do put out DC, which has to be converted into AC eventually. It's just where you do it. And that is kind of the rest of the story.
Now you know the rest of the story.
So what else we have? Got a question about natural gas. But half of it was hacked to death by my spam filter. So I've got a bunch of black things. Apparently somebody sent me something. I don't know who it's from. All I got is, hi, Dave, what do you see natural gas? Is it getting close to the washout? I think that if you wanted to take a stab at natural gas, what you want to do is see it in this gap. That gap is right around, take a look at it. It closes 1834 on the high to 1866. So you get into that with light volume over the next couple of days. That is where you want it to hold, and that's probably where you want to buy it. You don't need that much in the way of a stop. Anything probably below, much below 1799, on the UNG would tell you that you're on the wrong side of this, a close below that 1799. But we shall see. Good time of year to get it. I just continue to see huge amounts of crude production, and with that, you're going to get a lot of natural gas production. The only thing I can tell you long term is if the parties switch, that most of the people that are calling the shots now in the House are behind a plan to get rid of all natural gas. I don't know what they think we're going to use for electricity. They got rid of coal. Now they're going after natural gas. I guess we're just going to sit in and freeze all winter. But, I mean, these guys are, these people, are, of course, proposing this are dumb as a box of rocks. But elections have consequences. When Obama came to power, he said he would wipe out every coal plant and coal miner that he could find. We're basically hearing the same kind of rhetoric. And I think voters be damned. Of course, anybody working in the natural gas business also be damned. So just, you know, you can know, depending on which way you think that the election's going to go in a year and a half or so, that you want to keep an eye on it. Elections do have consequences. And that may mean that I sweat all day down here in Florida because we use both coal and natural gas, but I think they'll probably outlaw coal in the next rev that anybody gets. But natural gas, much better. Okay, give me a call at 877-927-6648. And we'll look at some other stuff. Oh, we were looking at earnings. So let's get back to that. See if there was anything else I wanted to look at. We didn't get to tolls yet, TOL. Now, it's down. As Tom O'Brien said yesterday in his show, the average price of a Toll Brothers home right now is north of $800,000. This is not very representative of the market, since less than 5% of homes now sell for $800,000. But on the high end, you've got to figure that the tax change, where you're not able to write off a great deal of your local taxes, especially in California and New York, where a great deal of Toll Brothers houses are, is probably going to affect them much more than anybody else. We'll be back in a minute.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com. educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Hey, what else do we have? Okay, let's take a scenario that the Fed launches QE in the next 6 weeks. The SPX begins to rally 3,100, 3,200. If that were to occur, would you have any guesses on which industry groups will do better than the, I would assume, in the SPX? Really thinking that biotech has been so quiet for so long that eventually that thing's going to get a huge move. It's got a lot of political headline risk, but it's lagged far behind the rest of the sectors for a number of years. And I've thought throughout this year that we were going to see that change and it was going to get back into a leadership position. Even with the political football, PE ratios on them have dramatically come down in the companies that, you know, are not ludicrously priced already. So I continue to think that that biotech sector has the opportunity for the biggest move through the fall, but don't have a lot of signs yet in that. Had a question about Palo Alto Networks. This one did go with heavy volume down into the August 19th low. So I think that that's got a challenge 194.67 low from that June 7th low once again, kind of bounced a little bit above it, but I still suspect this thing needs to base out a little bit. Take a quick look at the IBV out here, but this is generally a fairly decent pattern for a big long triangle. And I think when this thing finally breaks out, maybe it takes another 2 to 4 weeks, but I think when this the biotech starts moving, I think this thing's going to move rather quickly and much higher as they've done a fairly good job of raising earnings, but everybody's always been afraid that the big bad politician is going to come and rain on it, which has held it back, which makes it, of course, when it does start moving, probably a ton of catch up. And we know how the IBB can run once it starts getting moving. In fact, I think a lot of earnings in the biotech space that are there has been hidden to make sure that people didn't yell and scream at them about making too much money. I think that that does have an issue out there. Another question coming through on the UVXY. Out here, so we'll take a look at that. Again, I just suspect that this thing's probably headed back down. It decays rapidly, hasn't come back that far on volume so far, but I do think that just the inherent decay in this, especially through Memorial Day, could easily see this below the 23, 43, July 24th low. All you have to do is go sideways and this thing probably hits 2343 if we get any kind of movement into Memorial Day or Labor Day. I can't even remember it with 5 minutes. The 2nd of September. You really want to take a look at it after that period. Historically, a horrible time to be buying volatility, as it tends to peter out quite quickly. Okay. What your toes tell you about your Alzheimer's chance. I don't believe that. What else do we have? Well, one of the questions is why am I a little bit more bullish? And that is this V&Q, which is the REITs and real estate fund. This every time since 2010 has led the way down in the market. And while you're up here on fairly light volume, there's no real sign that this thing wants to blow up. Still has, in fact, I went kind of bullish at the lows last week, started buying stuff mostly because this is holding up so well. You know, this thing closes back below 90 or 89. I'm going to feel a lot more, but that'll be it. Okay. What else do we have? Oh, we wanted to look at a lot of these charts. Do I have enough time? Got 3 minutes. We'll go through as many as we can in the time we can. Artibus Biopharma, ABUS. I like the pattern on this thing. Testing 800,000 shares at $1.42 to 137,000 shares at $1.38 and going sideways. If you like playing the pennies, this one does look fairly good. ALTR, which is Altair Engineering, and it's not showing me too much here. Let's go to a little shorter time frame. Okay, A.O. Smith, this, of course, is a water heater company. He's had a good run off the lows. You've had light volume the last couple of days, but it's in the trading range, and it really hadn't rolled over, and it hasn't given a signal that everything's going to hell in a handbasket. Gold, Asante AU, one you want to keep a very close eye today on. Previous high, almost 5 million shares on August 7th. Got tested yesterday with 3.3 million shares. Today it's got 1.6 million shares, 1.7 so far. So you're back up into this high on very, very light volume on AU. So you want to watch that over the next couple of days. Bank of New York Mellon. Don't know why you'd need a Bank of Mellons, but these guys are, I guess, your deal. 14 million shares back on June 20th at 41.85. Got into it with just 3.58 million shares. Today he's down on 1.7 million shares. Hadn't given a signal that it's ready to run higher, but certainly not a lot of juice on the way back lower. That consolidates out, could be ready to go back higher by first week in September. What else do we have? COOP, Mr. Cooper, I don't see much in that one. Corcept Therapeutics testing its previous $13.03 high on March 4th with 1.3 million shares. Spiked it with 840,000 shares. Last couple of days, 700,000 shares today, just 400,000 shares. So there are some weak stocks out there. Some of the other ones I wanted to talk about today was Intercontinental Exchange. The market for them, ICE is the symbol. So you've gotten into a previous high on August 9th, did so with 1.7 million shares. Last 3 days, you've had 1.6, 1.3, and 700,000 shares. Question is, do you get a sign of strength? As we saw in many stocks this morning, like Home Depot and Lowe's and those kind of things with the big gaps. This is sitting right at the highs. Not showing that it's ready to pull up quite yet. We'll be right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And I got a couple of minutes here, and I promised I would answer a question for somebody, and they said, my time spending in television, movies, special effects, and Hollywood, did I meet any famous people? And I would say yes, briefly. They asked if I had any great stories about working in Hollyweird. I said, just the one that really kind of stuck with me. Most of the time, it was incredibly brief meetings with people like Ron Howard or other directors and some actors. I mean, these guys are constantly on the go, and you don't slow them down very much. They've got a lot of stuff to do, and most of it involves running to their trailer so they don't talk to other folk. But I do have to say that probably the funniest one was I was working with some folks that bought our products on Babylon 5, a kind of schlocky science fiction TV show, and of course one of the guys that was acting on it was Billy Mummy from Lost in Space, and I was a big fan of that as a kid. I even started building my own B9 robot. So it was kind of, you know, they say you shouldn't meet your heroes. Well, I met him, and he was your incredibly typical L.A. movie kind of gas bag. I was so disappointed in him. But everybody was sitting around eating lunch in the commissary next to the where they were filming it. And he was getting on one of his co-stars about eating meat. He says, I don't eat my friends. And they got in a big argument for it. Well, on the way to the parking lot, when everybody, the bell rang and everybody had to leave, we caught him hopping in his car, and the co-star leaned in the window and said, "We might not eat our friends, but I see that you sit on them." He had a leather interior car. I gotta remember that.
Larry Pesavento.